the whole universe is a human, and each of our part in the body is different places in the universe. Is it right or wrong?
Both right and wrong.
Both right and wrong.
What he is referring to is the classical Upanishadic description of the first human being. Or the first physical form, the first person. It is symbolic. In the language of the world, everything is material and direct. In the language of spirituality, everything is symbolic. It must not be taken on face value. When it is said that the universe is human, what is meant is that the universe and the human exist together and hence are one. You are seeing the universe as it appears only because you are what you are. If you were any different, the universe too would be different. Please understand. This is something. How is this something? This is something only because I can touch it. My eyes can have a look at it. And this whole form is appearing in the processes of the brain. The brain is the human being, is it not? So this and this, they are together. If this were any different, this too would be different. If the configuration of the brain changes, the universe would automatically change. And we cannot even guess what it would become. You know, it is like a code, a software. You know programming languages? You write it, and the code is such that it can be compiled by different compilers. Usually that does not happen. If you write a code in a language, only a compiler corresponding to that language can process it. But let there be a code such that different compilers correspond to different languages. If you compile it differently, the output would be totally different. Or those of you who have studied mathematics, who know that the value of a number depends totally on the base of counting. For example, if the base is binary, then 1 has one particular value, whereas if the base is 10, then 1 has another value. The value of this, the form of this, the appearance of this depends totally on the brain. There are several small hints available. If something happens to this, this changes. For example, if you take some drugs, you may find that this has become curvaceous. Does it become or not? Or if somebody slaps you hard here, you may find that this has become 7 fingers. Does that happen or not? So this changes and the world changes. And that is only small change, just a momentary hit on the head. What if the total fundamental configuration changes? Then you cannot even imagine what this pillar can become. We perceive visual wavelengths only between 4000 and 8000 angstrom. We receive oral wavelengths only between 20 and 20,000 hertz. That is our world. What if your mind starts receiving wavelengths outside of these limits, do you think the universe will remain the same?
No.
You perceive only a three-dimensional universe. Do you know that is such a fundamental configuration of the brain? What if the universe becomes five-dimensional? What do you think? Time and all are outside? They are all resultant and coexistent with the configuration of the brain. So the human and the universe are in fact always together. That is why the universe of the insect is not the same as the universe of the human being. The insect looks at the universe very, very differently. For the insect, even time moves very differently. 10 hours may be a lifetime for an insect, equivalent to 10,000 years. So when it is said that the universe is a human, it must be understood what it is saying. It does not mean that it is actually some human being. Great things are always expressed in subtle ways. Subtle matters have to be expressed subtly. Do not have crude interpretations of subtle things. Otherwise, you will miss, totally miss.